What evil genius would burrow a high-tech bunker 120 metres into the snow and rock of an Arctic island? Well, genius, yes, but evil it ain't. It's the Arctic Seed Vault, built to store a copy of all the world's crop genetics. Victorian grain grower and scientist Tony Gregson is one of the few Australians to have visited.
It was a wonderful visit, and we took one box of Australian seeds.
That box came from the temperate crops collection here in Horsham. Now, as important as the Arctic bunker is, it's just a big fridge, a backup for the priceless work of the world's top seed banks. In that department, Australia's grain growers are getting a giant upgrade with the formation here of the Australian Grains Gene Bank.
Access to dynamic germplasm collections is really important for Australian plant breeders and researchers. Australia doesn't have any native plant species for the commercial grain crops, so we're reliant on amassing germplasm from around the world and putting them into maintained seed libraries.
The Horsham collection's been priceless to our southern grains industry for years. The arrival of the key winter cereals collection from Tamworth and the summer crops from Biloela makes the AGG the central genetic resource for Australian grain crop breeding.
The idea of forming a national gene bank has been around for more than 15 years. The development of the national RD&E framework has been the impetus for the GRDC and the Victorian government to make a major investment to make it happen.
For those who use the gene bank, plant breeders, life is about to get much better. The first big improvement they'll notice is the way they access material via a nice new combined database. For the longtime curator of the Victorian collection, it's like a dream come true.
All of it. It'll be available online with a shopping cart where you can tick off which ones you want. Mm. We haven't had that facility before. We haven't had a one-stop shop before.
Over near the car park, a new building is underway to house an expanded team and the greatly expanded and expanding collection.
This room here holds 10,000 seed samples at minus 18 degrees. In the new centre, the capacity will be 18 times that much, which makes it a really significant resource.
But you can't just store seed. Over time, it'll degrade and lose the ability to germinate, even at minus 18. It has to be grown out to produce fresh stock. As it happens, that's exactly what you've got to do to add information about the samples you've got. It's called phenotyping. It's vital work that really adds value to the collection for breeders, especially when it turns up something as exciting as salt tolerance.
When we evaluated a cross-section out of this Chinese germplasm from Yunnan across to Harbin, we planted them all together and watered them with salt after they germinated, these two stood out as being very resistant to salt. They kept on growing almost normal.
It's a collection of global significance. Australian researchers such as our own Bob Redden are constantly searching out new sources of germplasm to put into the collection. Much of the collection we have here in Australia is unique and it's not held anywhere else in the world.
Like that box that went to Svalbard.
43 of the samples we took were chickpeas that were collected in the Lebanon back in the 1930s. And because the gene banks in that particular region now have been destroyed one way or another, the only samples of that particular material left in the world was actually in Horsham. And now that material has been now safeguarded into Svalbard.
It won't be the last. Horsham's no war zone, but the Black Saturday fires were perilously close. The Arctic freezer exists because the work of seed banks, like this one, is worth protecting.